Monkey King is having a very good time, so he could be a good kill. HTTP bottom.
And he's going over towards bottom. He's looking over for Dabil. Comes in, has Massaros right to his side. The spear will land, and they should be able to get the kill to the Nature's Prophet. Moon gets first blood. That's good to come off the lane. And
I guess there isn't a whole lot of heroes this game. Oh, Jab's going in with a huge rolling boulder here. Monkey King being affected by the Dream Coil. Dominating spree for the Monkey King. Monkey King in trouble here. DP doing a whole lot of damage with that Exorcism. But just TPing out on the heroes. But they lost both the Monkey King as well as the Mars. Very good fight here.
I got that oh, sixth sense thinking that they'd catch someone.
Oh, level 3 Necro here. Lycan ult available as well.
They're going to go with the Dream Coil. That's going to hit on a DJ. Avoids the stun that rolls in as well as the finger. They get the kill there on a play hard. They'll look over a Yopaj. Boulder Smash lands, slowing him down, looking for the Geomagnetic Grip. That's not going to silence up this Puff just yet. Really not much by Raven at the moment.
Nice
still
spear.
To lock down this puck. Great spear coming in from Massaros. They get the kill as they use the Magnetize. They're going to continue for more. Genuel uses that ult. And it looks like this Abaddon is going to drop too. So, and they have the Wolves scouting, so this is just becoming a bit of an issue. They've got the roll as well as the Arena. The Spike Carapace hits on both these heroes. They've got themselves a two-man coil and the Sun hitting from Playhard. They'll use that Wukong, so they get the kill to Jabs. They'll take out this Earth Spirit first. Earth Spike lands onto the Nyx Assassin. They've got Puck in their sights, but I'm not sure they've got Puck in their hands. As Death will come over and look for more, but roll over onto Playhard Spike Carapace. Now there's the Impale.
Easy to disengage.
Nothing more. Boulder Smash, not going to land, but there's the Arena come through on a Playhard. He doesn't have the Spike Carpus to work with anymore, but he'll get the Autophotic Shield. Now the Spike Carpus comes off cooldown. That's going to hit onto both this line as well as the Mars. They've got the Dream Coil down on a 2 as they'll come in, roll to the back lines, get themselves the X, or get themselves the ult from Jabs. Ballast Strike on the 3. Wukong's command is used, and they'll lose Genuel. But two heroes dead on both sides. Now Radiant, they got to think, do they want to go back in? This isn't moving forward. They'll look over. Lion getting caught here, and yeah, you can see that damage coming in. Dream Coil used, Lycan caught.
He has no BKB.
And they're going to get the spear out on a Genuel, but it's not really going to do anything. They get the kill there on the Yopaj. They'll look over as Lycan's getting low. They get the kill on a Raven. They're going to look for more as BKB is Moon, and he'll get out in time. Looking for the roll, but there's the Yules coming in and out onto the Earth Spirit as spear lands from Massaros.
Right. Farming under vision. Monkey King in trouble here.
Yo, over a little bit to the side, but Playhard lands the stun, and they have caught Moon. So let's see how are they going to turn this around, Black. This is we thought it was going to be a snowball out of control for Fnatic. Come in, Boulder Smash, Spear. Okay, they're going after this Abaddon, but again, I think this is not the hero that you really want to focus on. Gonna go after Massaros. Look at the damage coming in onto the Mars. Jabs goes onto the back lines and again is trying to use that Magnetize to get a kill here on a Death. They'll lose Genuel. Abaddon's the one they get, but they need to get more out of this if they want to feel confident about coming into the rest of this game. And well, right now, Playhard, he'll fall too. That's two kills here for Moon. Getting taken away here, but they're ready for this. And they're gonna go onto Massaros. They've got the stun. There's the dag, and the hex is out onto the puck. Can they get the kill here? They're gonna look over as they use the finger, but the end is gonna be popped, so they end up staying alive. The Gluttony used on a DJ. They get the kill there onto the Lion.
If Monkey gets on top of Prophet, Prophet's in trouble. And if Lycan gets on top of him, he's also in trouble.
Smoke breaks, and there's the blink out of the back lines again going into Genuel, but he's not over on a Death. Death is Yules up into the air, and we'll use that Exorcism. They'll use the Dream Coil, but the BKB gets popped.
Death in trouble!
Finally going after the Death Prophet. Can they get the kill on a Death? They finally drop this Death Prophet. They look over at Genuel, but Moon ends up dead! Oh dear, they lose the Monkey King pretty early on into this fight. Genuel is still standing, Raven gone, and that goes horribly for Fnatic. That is not what they wanted. They will lose Jabs 2 and Neon. Wow.
Monkey died without using Wukongs, without using BKB. The Nature's Prophet is dealing way too much damage. Massaros caught.
Massaros, he's caught, and I'm not sure he's getting out of this one. They're going to stick with him and use that dagger to finish him off. Four heroes dead on Fnatic.
Right, so careful.
Each other.
Monkey King can't die first.
Well, Primal Spring nearby. Silence doesn't land on the Moon. That was close. Dream Coil used, and that's going to snap immediately out of the Earth Spirit with the BKB being popped by Masaru. So go after this Nyx Assassin. They'll get the kill here on a Playhard with that Radiant Retreat, knowing that this isn't their fight to take or try and win. A Cat Januel, though, on the roll. Maybe turn this around. Exorcism used the BKB going after this Death Prophet. Death turning around has the Spirit Siphon out. Balance Strike lands, and now the damage coming in, but they've got themselves the Shivas as well as that Yules. He's surviving for now. Wukong's isn't going to be enough with the right clicks coming through. He's surviving for a little bit longer, but it's not going to be enough. They get the kill onto Death as well as Januel. They get the kill onto this Lion. So 3-for-1 with the buyback being committed from Abaddon. They're close by. I think Neon know that they need to go after somebody to try and lock down this Roche. And who they're going to go after is going to be this Earth Spirit, but the Spear lands on a Playhard. He's going to get the Aphotic Shield to be broken away from the side of the arena. They get the kill there on a Jabs as they look over with a finger and get the kill on a Playhard. So they end up trading 1-for-1 with the buyback being used by Jabs with the Balance Strike hitting on a Januel. He's invis for the moment, but they do have vision on him.
Geomagnetic being chased.
The roll coming in. The borrowed time is popped. Gletnir thrown over. Won't land, and they'll get the kill on a DJ. Or won't land onto the
Lycan. They'll
get the kill on a DJ as they look over, and now Yopaj and Disc trying to stay alive. Wait, this is a little bit not great for Fnatic. If they get caught any longer,
Lucan's
Balance Strike doesn't land. Good four staff.
That was a huge miss.
Roll in. It's a Geomagnetic Grip, and they're going to try and go after this Nyx Assassin. Dead for 90. And they've used Exorcism to go after Roche.
And that's 2 heroes dead without buyback. They can't fight the 3v5.
Whoa.
And Exorcism has been, as you said, also expended. Oh my god, this could be a huge moment for Fnatic. No Aeon Disc ready.
Going after Yopaj. He's gonna die if he's not too careful, and this is looking bad for him. Spear pushes the Death Prophet onto the high ground, and Death is away from his team, but the damage coming up from this Nature's Prophet isn't gonna be enough. They get the kill on the Jabs, they look over a Moon, he's got the BKB going, and the right click's coming through onto Defeal. He's hexed up, hit up into the air with the stun, and they'll get
he's
the kill
not dying.
On the Moon. Defeal's still hidden away, he's got the help from the Death Prophet. They'll take out Defeal finally, but he's gonna buy back, and you know he's TPing into the fight. They've got the arena down with the Gletnir being used, they'll look over at Raven, they've stunned up this Monkey King because the arena came in and took out the trees, but now Death, he's dead, and the Nature's Prophet goes back.
It's kind of funny to just see the Nature's Prophet not even walking anymore. Like, he's just TPing everywhere, even if it's just like 200 range. Oh, Yopaj! Death Notify on him!
Found Yopaj! B-Shift, can he get out of here? He's looking to leave, and now Finger used, but he's not out of the hands of Masaru's just yet. The stun's gonna land from Playhard. They've got the damage coming in from Death. Death on the front lines with Tavio coming in. Did have enough to hex out onto Death as
he's a lot of damage.
Sides, and I think he's not gonna make his way out of this one. Oh dear, this is going horrible for Death.
They're just popping in trouble! He's taken down, no buyback on him. DP bought back into the fight. Monkey King putting out a lot of pain here. DP without Exorcism is not nearly as scary. Yopaj is now the main damage dealer here. Can he kill all the heroes of Fnatic? You have to be so careful if you get caught out there. Abaddon getting killed by the Monkey King. Nullify. Oh, Dagon E-Black combo. He still has the Aegis, of course. Spear off the mark.
Back Monkey alive, King. And now they've got the Silence onto the Monkey King. They're going to try and chase. Ooh, this is aggressive coming out from Yopaj. He knows he needs to get something done. Illusory Orb.
Oh, he has Rapier Monkey. Be careful.
King. Does he jaunt? Oh, dear. E-Blade. Fuels up into the air. Maybe a little bit of miscommunication, but they've got the stun
he
out.
Drops
the
Rapier.
King. They will get that kill. The Rapier's on the deck. And they look over at Masaru's, who needs to leave the arena. He's trying to pull off that Dream Coil into the headband snap once again, but they've got the dagger. They get the kill out of Masaru's. Everybody dying except for Raven alive right now on Fnatic. Maybe want to, especially in 20 seconds, they can just go tier 4s.
I'm a little surprised they didn't go for the throne here. Like, they know that they bought back on Monkey. I can all getting popped, they want to get Rapier back. They want to get Rapier back, a second lot of damage.
Death Prophet down, Rapier picked up by the Lycan, and now he looks over and Playhard, DJ gone. Can
Prophet
they get
up.
Anything out of this? They've got Dabeel coming back into the fight, right? Wrath of Nature comes in, and here he is showing up. Do they have
it's
the damage?
Rapier on the Prophet.
Landing. There's the kill on a Raven. And now you've got the Rapier on the Nature's Prophet. Lycan dead for 94, and the throne getting taken out.
And this game is all but over now. Lycan bought back. We'll have to see if he can defend it by himself. Doesn't look very likely. So much damage coming out from his Prophet now with the Rapier. Don't think they can defend this. 10 seconds left until they respawn.
I don't think so either. Look at the damage just coming out on the jabs. They land the Gletnir. That comes in on Raven, and he will fall again. The throne is exposed. The GG is called, and Neon will
very free game so far. All three cores on the side of Fnatic top the CS board. Briefcase is coming out. Play hard. He's going to be all right.
Briefcase?
No, he's still going. Play hard. Careful, sir. That is a very hard briefcase. Yopage. Stomp is there. Play hard. Oh, he goes down to the end. DJ, he gets in, but the roll is out from Yopage. They'll get the trade.
Most likely to see that item build. I mean, it's the most standard item for a reason. Gives you a good setup, gives you a good save against the silences. Top lane. Weaver.
He's going to be all right. Maseros, he needs to be careful. Yopage, great rotation again. Magnetize popped, and Maseros, he is slowly but surely going to die to the magnetization of the Earth Spirit.
He's already 1700 ahead of the Weaver.
Auto smash, Yopage trying to roll out, but he does connect onto Moon. Now Inkswell is there. Genuel, he's going to try and help. He doesn't really have that much healing yet. The Yopage is still alive. Now a Grey Cox out, Death. He will save the day. Jabs trapped up with the clockwork. He'll die. Skem is also around. Oh, that is a fantastic Cox by Death.
Yep, saving his Earth Spirit and killing the Grimstroke. Unfortunately, not enough damage to kill.
Oh, DJ,
a little bit of trouble here.
Needs to bring out the briefcase again, but it's not looking that loaded. Plenty of control. He'll turn on to play hard. Phase shift.
Briefcase.
Can he get it in time? No.
Why not?
Very nice. Seems balanced.
He's filthy rich.
Roll. Dream coil. Bot lane. They've caught out the Grimstroke into the kick, and God, I love that combo. Kick him right out of that leash. Now Moon is actually quite surrounded.
Get out of here.
Got an astral step, but the silence is in. Yopage now rolling in with the magnetize, and he's silenced. Moon, dissimulate, is it going to be enough? He'll survive. Astral step to the pre-line, but he's going to die anyway. They at least get Genuel. They've stunned up the Earth Spirit, but Yopage, he's not done yet. With Skem, they'll go right onto DJ. The Order Titan is in trouble. While Death, he will hold Maseros back. Stampede doesn't look great. He gets pushed away. The hook shot to control. Maseros still in danger. Gets the Inkswell onto Genuel. Rather play hard. A big hoof stop, but it really won't matter.
The most simple winning condition you can get in Dota, pretty much.
Death,
in on the clock right here.
Inkswell gonna land, roll in, Yopage. He wants to try and protect the Earth, but they're gonna be pretty big, but play hard is there with the Dream Coil into the kick with the stop. DJ, barely saving the day, or maybe not. Aether Remnant Moon, he will make it out, but Yopage, he's gonna chase. He will chase Moon down and get the great roll. The regen might be a little bit too high. Yopage will continue to roll through, and they'll find DJ instead. Roll, not quite on target, but it won't matter. They should be able to get this. Still Raven now gonna turn around with the stun out, and the
big double stun.
Maseros controls them up. And Jabs, he lets them know about it. You should have known better. It's the puck. They've got another play hard. He's gone, and Fnatic.
Okay, no problem.
That's a turbo game for Raven. Hookshot, Death, Cogs, Battery Sword, everything being thrown out, but there's your Stampede. Raven is dropping a little bit lower, but not quite low enough. Yopage stun out again out of Raven. Earthspitter coming in with the hoof stomp. Oh, goodness me. This is looking bad. Neon do not have an answer, at least right now. Death, he's still trying to run. Raven, he's going to be on the chase. Have a drink, he says. Death, going to get stunned up, and another kill out for the Alchemist.
It's so tough.
Mid lane, Maseros looking for that initiation, does get the hoof stomp.
Item timings are coming out, it's just...
Yules out onto the Weaver. They've got Skem. Stomp won't be there in time. They're still chasing him down. Maseros, he gets the stun off. Now the hook shot from Death. It might be too late. Genuel, he's trying to help. He will not be able to, though. The IO has no healing going on. Fnatic will just clean them up again. They found Death now. Death, he could try to run, but there's no way in hell he's getting out.
Yeah, so how do you stop this Alchemist now? This is potentially the last fight for Neon here. See what they can
Maseros. Do. Maseros. Another great initiation. He found the mid-Earth Spirit. Yopage gonna die. Skem. He's come in, and so will Chanyuol, but Maseronx, he's so confident. Moose gonna move in. They'll find another. It's not even close. They got Chanyuol on the IO now. Buyback's committed, but this could be the last team fight. They are trying their best, but there's your Soulbind. Raven's in. He's already killed Playhard a second time. On to death, they'll get the clockwork. There are no buybacks.
No, Neon probably kind of digesting the loss, kind of thinking about what to do next.
He's trying to creep skip, magnetize Yapash. He's going to jump in and try and fight this one out right onto Maseronx. But he's going to be worried about Raven. Raven's just hitting him this whole time. The BKB not helping him out at all. Now they've caught the IO though. Chanyuol, he's gone, and Yapash will die again. Skem, he kills Jazz, but the GG's called. They've had enough.
GG. Yeah, it's unfortunate this game was super one-sided. More than 1k GPM advantage. They don't manage to find some good rotations with that puck, because the side lanes are not going very well for them right now. Sand King is suffering, so is Wraith King. Puck has a lot of work to do.
Speaking of the Wraith King, Raven, throwing up the stun onto Playhard, Icarus dive to boot, slowing Playhard down, and this should be a kill on the Pangon, they will get it. Raven actually able to take the kill.
That is true, that is true. Is there some sort of, is there a double void step here?
They are going in again onto Moon. They love going after this puck, and this
easy
time
kill.
They will be able to secure.
Catapult alive as well with the Abaddon here. And no danger of dying whatsoever. Wraith King top.
They are going to go. Fire strike out from Maseronx, but Raven is still in pretty massive danger. They've kind of left him behind. Now the egg's going to come in. Jabs. He is barely going to help. No, never mind. Raven is dead. They even get the egg. Maseronx, he will try to go for the epicenter, but death. He will not die. He is death itself. Moon goes down. Yapash, what an Aether Remnant out onto the Sand King mid Burrow Strike. He'll try to Sandstorm, but they have the dust. Yapash, he'll
They're
lead the charge.
Up at all.
On to DJ and the poor clockwork. He'll cogs up. Maseronx is also around in the Sandstorm. In fact, they're going to go after the big target. They go straight for the Sand King into the clockwork. And they are making it look so easy.
A very big problem. Phoenix, is he going to get out?
Yeah, Jabs gets jumped on. There's the Yule Scepter into the Aether Remnant. Do they have complete control? It does look like they do.
Easy. Absolutely easy for them.
Maseronx, already been a tough game for him. He's gonna find out the hard way, but oh, nice blink out. It's just not gonna matter. Yapash, he's all over it. They've got the control, and look at the damage output.
And so is DP, really. Like, they have so much damage on this Dire side, just passive damage, which I've spoken about before. Coil on the Pangolier here should be
a pretty
easy kill.
Leash almost about to wear off. I don't know if it is. They hookshot in. He is still alive, but finally does go down to Moon. They have lost
Wraith
another,
King.
Though. Jabs is down, and now the Wraith King Raven.
And you can't blame them. The entire map control is going to Neon right now.
Oh, top lane.
Now initiation tanking here.
He's trying his best to split push that top lane and make more space, but every single time he does, he gets punished. What do you do? Raven eventually will scale on this Wraith King, but it's going to take a while, and now they're going to smoke. They're going to try with those double blinks you talked about.
Puck down trouble here.
He is in trouble
for full health.
Oh no, they're going to go in anyway. Burrow Strike is out. They've got the Abaddon. That is a hard target. They'll hookshot and instead onto the Pango, and Playhard is going to die, but Maseronx has been caught again by the Remnant. Yapash not going to capitalize. He'll back off, but here comes Death Summer right onto Raven. They want the big boy, but Epicenter is in. It's not going to be great, however. Right onto Chanyuol. Maseronx.
The egg.
Eats the back. Dream Coil's there. Moon holds them down into the egg, but where's the damage output? Maybe it's coming in. Moon, he's been caught out. He's very low on that puck. He will die a second time. A dieback immediately. They do at least kill off Yapash. There's something for Fnatic, but Scammy, he's just tipping them while he's taking their racks. He's torturing them. Moon, he's caught out again.
The caught out again.
He's going to connect. The Rolling Thunder, it's all there. Moon, he just respawned. The tips again from Playhard. So, he's just going to get it up. Almost there. Bot lane, however. Maseronx Remnant out. Yapash, he's got him. The silence is going to make it impossible.
The problem is that DP is really strong against Wraith King. Like, even through BKB, those Exorcism Ghosts, especially if you don't have AC, are going to absolutely just eat you up. Like, he's going to die through BKB in like 3-4 seconds anyways.
Oh, Yapash, he's in. He's got jabs. Jabs. Oh, Burrow Strike. Maseros, he's going to save the day. The egg is out. Maybe this is the fight. Play hard. He's gone. Yapash, he's going to juke out the egg stun with the Yules. Ate the Remnant. Hold one down. Raven, he's joined in. He wants to fight, but here they go. Neon, they'll turn right back around. Raven,
oh, Raven
he doesn't
trouble.
Want to be here anymore. He wants to run, but the life, at least the first one's gone. Maseros, he's back in. Double Burrow Strike out. Buybacks being fitted. Play hard, but look at your Wraith King. The king is dead. Moon. He'll get his way. Oh no. He is not
oh, he's
out.
He's getting used up. Remnant, easy pickoff as well. Maybe Leshrac here is all by himself, but he's so tanky with Shiva's BKB Bloodstone.
Oh, they're going in. Epicenter. It's a lot of damage. Hookshot. Is it enough? Not quite yet.
They can't
Skelly
kill him.
He's going to survive. They can't kill him. They can't kill him. He's going to turn right back around.
He's killing all of
gone
them.
Out. Everyone is just burning alive. Raven, he's been left behind. He'll BKB TP out. But how demoralizing when you commit everything on one hero.
They have no damage to kill him. And they use so many ults for him. Now DP ult popped. How do they defend this barracks with MLP? How?
You're the analyst, Black. You need to tell me these questions.
Well,
around
I
these
don't
answers.
Know. Like, this is way beyond my analysis capability. Like, I can't see a single thing.
Oh, goodness me. Death right onto the mid racks. Raven, he's looking at him. He's trying to give him a death stare, but they don't care. Back in, Maseros, he Burrow Strike, Yules up, Skem, again, the control, the damage. It's too much. Hookshot, DJ, he's gonna try. Cox pushback, but Raven, already one life down. There's Maseros with the buyback now. And the Burrow Strike. They're gonna continue trying, but Raven's gone.
Well, he didn't even have his BKB in his inventory. Like, he died with his BKB in his backpack.
Alright,
a little bit flustered here. But now, Mega Creep's coming out.
Onto the park. Dissimilate there. Moon almost dies. Maseros goes down again. They call it. GG is called. Neon Esports, or rather OB Neon. They do make it through to the round two of the lower bracket of the playoffs. And I'd hate to say it, but Fnatic...